I'm not sacrificing today for the promise of tomorrow. Sometimes people tell me, they're like, bro, you should just work hard and save your money and, invest. And even if it's a job you hate, just, it's all about getting rich and, living better later. We work hard now so we can enjoy life tomorrow, but tomorrow's not even promised. And I don't want the shit that money can buy for the most part. I mean, look, I like peace of mind that money has to offer, but I don't have to have so much of it to get that peace of mind, right? If I were to live in a trailer and make, $1,000 a month, which is easily obtainable working part-time, and compared to, and I had almost all my free time, I could just hang out, I could just live in the moment, right? I'm not a slave to some job. I'm not going somewhere doing something I hate that doesn't provide real value to the world, like selling insurance, like when I used to sell insurance. How is that making the world a better place? How am I, when I'm dead and gone, if I can look back from the next life, if such a thing exists, how am I gonna be proud of that? Like, oh, I worked hard, I brought home the bacon, but I spent the money on bullshit, right? And then I don't have my time back either. So I lost my time and I lost my money. And what am I left with? What am I left with? I'd rather live in the moment, do something I love, even if I have to starve for a little while. Because the money comes in slowly when you do stuff you love, So even if I have to go hungry for a little bit, but I'm loving what I'm doing and I feel like I'm making a difference, I feel like I'm, leaving this place more better off than before I came into it, right? This life. To me, that's worth so much more than making more money doing something I hate, selling my soul. To what? To buy cheap trinkets? To buy a Mercedes? I had a Mercedes. I got bored of it in 2 weeks. I didn't want the Mercedes anymore. The most miserable point in my entire life was when I was working my high-paying sales job, and I had a brand new Mercedes, and I had a pocket full of money, and I had never been more miserable in my entire life because all I wanted was good people around me. All I wanted was people that loved me for me. I didn't want the stupid fucking trinkets. I just wanted good people around me, but you can't buy good people. You have to earn them. And to some people, that's a curse. To some people, that's a blessing because some of the best people I've ever met in my life, I met them when I was broke. Some of the worst people I ever met in my life, I met them when I was doing better. So, to me, good people are everything. To me, having a good, social circle is everything. I don't want to be a slave. I don't want to do something that I hate for money. I don't understand that. We were meant to live. Everything we need in this life, we were born with. Everything that makes you happy in life either comes from within inside you or it grows out of the ground. You don't need to be out there chasing nonsense. We're all out there chasing happiness. Happiness is like a plant. It grows. You water it, you treat it good, you love it. Happiness is not out there at some corporate job. It's not in the driver's seat of some sports car. It's not having your arm around some fucking supermodel looking chick. It's about having people that love you for you, throughout thick and thin, throughout your highs and lows. You don't own anything in this life, right? You think 'cause you put your name on a piece of paper that says, oh, property of whoever, that you own your house or you own your car. You don't own anything. I can take your life away in 2 seconds, and you can take my life away too if you really wanted to. This life is fragile and it's all about experiences. And I'm done sacrificing today for the promise of tomorrow so that I can have experiences or I can hope for experiences when I can just make less money and have those experiences now. Why do I have to, why do I have to prolong it? You know, what am I trying to build here? I see people that are way richer than me, that have way less money than me. I see people that live in crummy neighborhoods, right? They don't really have anything. They drive old beat up cars, but they have each other, right? They have each other, and that's all they need. And then, you know, myself for an example, I've had periods in my life where I'm making a shitload of money and I'm coming home to an empty apartment, and all I want to do is just fucking hang myself, because I'm like, what is this? What am I doing here? I just worked 40 hours this week, or I just worked 60 hours this week for what? I have these green slips of paper in my pocket that really don't do anything for me. All I can do is, you know, pay my bills with them, which is good, but that's really the extent of the value of money. After that, all I can do is buy trinkets with my money. And I get bored of the trinkets. The trinkets get old. I want something that has life in it. I want something or someone, you know, that loves me for me. I don't want trinkets, you know. You go to work, you know, you do a job you hate, and then you get money, and then you blow the money, but you can't get your time back. You go to work and you pay taxes. If you make $40,000 a year, you pay 40% taxes at the end of it. Income tax, state tax, fuel tax, sales tax, whatever the hell. You know, you're left with, I don't know, $28,000, right? So you work 100% of the time to make 60% of the money, right? But they don't give you back the 40% of your time that you lost. So you lose 100% of your time, but you only keep 60% of the money. What even is that? What kind of life is that? Now, if I was working like part-time, right, and I'm just chilling the rest of the time, you know, and I have more free time, I wouldn't mind something like that. But to spend your whole life working some job only to pay 40% of it in taxes and then bills and everything, what are you even left with in the end? You know, you're gonna find a way to spend the rest of the money somehow. What I would do, because I was so miserable at the job, I would find myself blowing all the money just to be happy, just to make up for how empty I felt, being so lonely working the job and not being with my friends or whatever. I would just go out and blow the money out of anger, almost, on shit I didn't even want. You know, I would not even be hungry, and I would go out to a fucking expensive dinner. I would go buy a car for no reason, you know? I didn't need another car. I went and bought a fucking Mercedes. I didn't need a Mercedes. I had a perfectly good Honda, but I'm like, dude, I'm so lonely and empty. I need a Mercedes to fill the void. And of course, you know, for like a week or two it did, but then, like everything else, you come down from that high and then it's back to reality. I don't know. You need good people. You don't need stuff. And the beautiful thing about good people is they are free, you know? You don't have to pay me to listen to me or to comment on my videos or whatever. Of course, I always appreciate it when people pay me. But you didn't have to work 80 hours a week and climb to the top of the corporate ladder to find me in my videos, did you? You kind of just stumbled across me, you know? Like, it was a luck sort of thing. It wasn't a hard work sort of thing. As humans, I don't think we were meant to work that hard. I don't think we were meant to really work at all, honestly. I mean, all the food we need grows out of the ground. You just have to walk up to it and eat it, you know? We didn't have to have steak and lobster. We didn't have to have champagne. We were meant to get by without it. You know, maybe that's just the vegan in me talking. It just sort of helps me see how sick and twisted this life we live is and how delusional it is, because we can get by on so much less. And it's just, people work so hard for nothing, honestly. At the end of the day, what do you have to show for it? When you're on your deathbed, was it worth it, really? You know? I don't know.